To become a Blue Blood football program, you need to beat the Blue Blood programs. Yeah, that was PJ Fleck's message ahead of the 2020 Outback Bowl in Tampa Bay, Florida. And as Minnesota Gophers, yeah, they deliver. Minnesota defeated 12th ranked Auburn 31-24 on New Year's Day, taking down one of the SEC's top teams in front of thousands of Maroon and Gold fans. Now that the offseason is upon us, let's take a look back at the 2019 season. It's easy to forget Minnesota's shaky start. The Gophers snuck out wins by just one possession over South Dakota State, Fresno State, and Georgia Southern. But Minnesota found their footing in a 40-17 win over Illinois back on October 5th. And yeah, the team seemed to never look back. Now, on October 13th, the Gophers, then 6-0, found themselves in the AP Top 25 poll for the first time since 2014. Minnesota rose all the way up to number 8 in the polls after arguably its biggest win in a half a century, the 31-26 victory over undefeated and 4th-ranked Penn State at home. Now, the losses to rivals Iowa and Wisconsin were the only blemishes on what was an unforgettable season for Minnesota, which secured its first 11-win season since 1904. Folks, that's a gap of 115 years. The Gophers, though, couldn't have had their memorable campaign without star senior Tyler Johnson, the Minneapolis North product, who arguably will go down as the best Gophers receiver in school history. Johnson capped off a historic career by catching 12 passes for 204 yards and 2 touchdowns against Auburn, passing Ron Johnson in the record books for the most career receiving touchdowns and Eric Decker for the most career receiving yards. There is no doubt that we'll be watching Johnson on Sundays next year. And as for the Gophers, they still have a lot of work to do to be recognized as a Blue Blood program, but 2019 was a big first step.